Hello friends, I'm Dr. Tamim. I'm here with Dr. Hamsa. She's got a very good rank in this recently conducted INICT. Please introduce yourself, tell your rank and your college.
Myself, Dr. Hamsa from Mangalore Medical College. My INICT All India rank is 138. I was in Bangalore regular batch and also was a foundation batch student. I want to thank my family, my friends and old TBMCF faculty, especially Dr. Tamim sir, who was like, his life section Rajas sir used to motivate us a lot, and also Dr. Rajas sir and Aziz sir who has made microbiology easy, and old TBMCF faculty.
Hamsa, I think those who are listening to this interview will definitely want to know how was your pattern of study and how did you prepare? So when did you start preparing and how was your journey?
I started from March 2020 after my internship. My classes began in April. So till then I had some foundation batch books. So I used to go with that. And later when classes started, I used to attend the classes and finish off that on the same day. So I used to revise and also do the MCQ before the next class. Classes got over by September and October. We had five sections, and before November INICT, I completed my one revision and also had a rapid revision of 1 week before the exam, and my All India rank was 626 then. NEET got postponed, and I started doing revision. April again exam got postponed, and by July INICT section I was able to do some 7 to 8 revisions, and then my ranking was 477. Then before NEET I got one more revision, and my NEET rank was not good, it is 3800, because the only mistake I did over there was my 3 and a half exam hours. Like, I got freaked a lot and I doubted myself a lot. So immediately of the exam was knowing it, and my exam didn't go well, I'm gonna get a bad rank. After that I just prepared for some 10-15 days before the exam for November INICT, and now my rank is 138. Just go to class notes. Class notes are very sufficient. Do the MCQs. And for INICT, mainly it's like last 5 years ka paper. If we are thorough with the questions and also topics, we can answer to in INICT. And for NEET, questions won't repeat though. But nowadays it's becoming conceptual. So only with the DBMC notes is more than enough, and also the previous year ka paper and giving GTs.
Great. I think you've really given a very good overview of how one should prepare and how your journey was. So I think really remarkable from 3000, I think you've come to now 138. I think it's really very fantastic. So how was your revision the last few, about 2 months before the exam, what were you really doing?
2 months before the exam, I used to start the revision with the class notes, and at the end of the day, some 1 hour I used to do the MCQs, like previous year MCQs or some I took the final sprint of DBMCI, and I used to give one final sprint or something. Then or else I used to do some MCQs for last 1 hour or 2 hours. And all notes. I used to keep last 10 days for my rapid revision. I used to go all the previous year topics and some important forgettables. I used to be done with that. And also vibe book. All vibe section, because some vibe were like that, you can finish off your revision in that vibe. If you go through the vibe images, I was able to finish off the revision itself, one more small revision.
I think you've done very well. So we're all very proud and happy for you. I'm sure you've done great for your college also. So best wishes, and hope you have a very good career. Any final words you want to say before I end?
I want to suggest my juniors that never doubt yourself. Never doubt yourself. And throughout, whenever you get in GTs 2, you get a low score. Don't underestimate you or doubt yourself. And especially before the exam day, and don't stress yourself a lot, because that was a mistake I did in my NEET. I broke down before the exam day. I started crying at night. I don't know why I freaked a lot. That's the mistake I did in my NEET exam. Though my GT score was good, I was doing good in my all the GT in NEET booster pack. I don't know, like, I doubted myself all of a sudden and I did my NEET INCO well. So be confident I am answering. Then don't doubt yourself and follow the TBMC faculties what I tell, because then don't go running behind all the, and some questions which are like
some hi-fi questions, weird questions.
Hi-fi questions, like, just follow what the faculties tell.
So I think very good advice. What you're suggesting is many of the things have got super specialty level questions that may not really be beneficial for you at the end of the day. So I think what you've given is a very clear approach to what one should do for this profession. So thank you so much, Hamza, and I hope you have a very good career ahead. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.